The first reading is written in the Gospel of St. Luke, the 23rd chapter, beginning at the 32nd verse. Two other men, both criminals, were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, there they crucified him, along with the criminals, one on his right, the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they divided up his clothes by casting lots. Hank. Our responsive reading. Dogs have surrounded me. A band of evil men has encircled me. They have pierced my hands and my feet.
I count all my bones. People stare and gloat over me.
They divide my garments among them
and cast lots for my clothing.
We will now sing stanza 1 of hymn 143. Stanza 1 of hymn 143.
Second reading is from Luke, chapter 23. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself, if he is the Christ of God, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above him, which read, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him, "Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God?" he said. "Since you are under the same sentence, we are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "I tell you the truth, today you will be with me in paradise." Second responsive reading. O Lord, rebuke me not in your anger, nor chasten me in your displeasure.
Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal me in my distress.
For in death there is no remembrance of you. In the grave, who shall give you thanks?
The Lord has heard my supplication. The Lord will receive my prayer.
We continue with stanzas 2 and 3.
Lord, taste my taste, Lord, taste my taste.
The third reading is from John chapter 19. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. The third responsive reading. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and let my cry come to you.
Hide not your face from me in the days when I am in trouble. Incline your ear unto me when I call.
My days are like a shadow that wanes, and I am withered like the grass.
But you, O Lord, shall endure forever, and your remembrance unto all generations.
We continue with stanza 4. The fourth reading is from Matthew, chapter 27. From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" The fourth responsive reading. My God, why have you forsaken me?
Why are you so far from saving me, so far from the words of my groaning?
Oh my God, I cry out by day, but you do not answer.
By night, and am not silent.
Continue with stanza 5. Fifth reading is from John, the 19th chapter. Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. The fifth responsive reading. Scorn has broken my heart and has left me helpless.
I looked for sympathy, but there was none.
They put gall in my food
and gave me vinegar for my thirst.
We continue with stanza 6. The sixth reading is from John 19. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. The sixth responsive reading. O Lord, rebuke me not in your wrath, neither chasten me in your displeasure.
For my iniquities are gone over my head, and as heavy burden, I can bear them no more.
I am troubled. I am bowed down greatly. I go mourning all day long.
I am feeble and sore broken. I have cried out by reason of the disquietness of my heart.
My heart pants. My strength fails me. The light of my eyes is gone from me.
Forsake me not, O Lord. O my God, be not far from me.
We continue with stanza 7. The seventh scripture reading is from Luke, the 23rd chapter. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last.